There is always a cause behind every action, no matter how unimportant it may sound. The motive of that action, though, can differ from person to person, depending on what they know. Thus, the cause falls under the notion of reasoning, while the motive is subject to rationality. The thing here is that a reason can never be judged, because it is simply what causes an action to happen. Only the rationality behind it can, and only in a volume of how rational or irrational the action sounds to be, depending on the circumstances under which it happened. For example, let's say someone became an alcoholic. The reason was because his wife left him. The rationality of this act is because he believed drinking would take the pain away. Which is pretty irrational, because it will only ruin his life further. There can be multiple interpretations for why something happened, because every person can view an action differently. What has happened may externally look the same for everyone, but the explanation of why it happened can be completely different. If we use the same example from before, although the person who became an alcoholic has a reason which is justified in his mind, many others may have a different explanation because they have incomplete information, or are misinformed, or are looking at the whole thing from a completely different perspective that leads them to completely different conclusions. If I use a more extreme example, let's say someone beats another man almost to death. The reason was because he couldn't control his anger. The onlookers may think it's because he's a very violent and dangerous man, but if later they learn that the man that got beaten had raped the attacker's wife, then the whole situation will now feel completely different, and even reasonable under the circumstances under which it happened. And now if I take this notion back to anime, everything that happens in a show has a reason for happening, and usually there is a justification provided by the show of why someone did something. Superficially, that is enough to accept anything they tell you or show you. But if you're a critical thinker who doesn't accept anything they throw at you, you will realize that many times the rationality of a show is complete bullshit. For example, this guy on Reddit tried to make it seem like the example I mentioned with Usopp and Luffy in the forgiveness topic is mistaken. There is a very good reasoning of why they fought. It's because they weren't taking the whole piracy thing seriously and that they should start acting more mature about it. Right, because they were totally mature afterwards. This reasoning implies that there should be character development, and there was no such thing. The same logic follows many other cases I mentioned in previous videos, such as the riddles in Zankyu no Terror. There was a reason for them to exist, but the reasoning is nonsensical. If the protagonists were as smart as they claimed, they wouldn't waste their time like that. So, regarding that, there are several remarks that can be made. Number 1. Disagreeing with the mentality of a character is no excuse to dislike the whole show. People who hate characters like Shinji from Neon Genesis or Makoto from School Days do it because they don't like their reasoning, and not because there is something actually wrong with the show. The real issue is when they say one thing and yet they do something completely different. This inconsistency is what makes them hypocrites, or plain badly written. So basically, you're not supposed to hate a show for not accepting its logic. It was written to be like that, and there is nothing wrong with being what it is. You're supposed to criticize it only for not having consistency between reason and motive. Number 2. Many anime try to get away with this inconsistency by making the characters mentally or emotionally unstable. Basically, by having a cast made up of hormone-crazy teenagers with mental scars is the ultimate alibi for doing anything and making sense exactly because it doesn't make sense. You get all-time classic excuses of the sort, "They are teenagers!" and "People make mistakes!" And although it is so, a fictional work needs to have some sort of logic for the audience to follow it, and not to be completely random to the point everything is accepted as whatever. It's impossible to like or identify with something if it is formless and unidentified. Number 3. Many anime are deliberately leaving things vague and open to interpretation so the audience can give any explanation it wants. This is when we call a show ambiguous, because its message is not clear, because it deals with grey morality. That sort of approach is very interesting because it doesn't try to spoon-feed you with some sort of agenda, but rather lets you decide if the agenda presented is beneficial or harmful. Though there are two problems that usually ruin that. A. The first being how it's very hard for a show to remain impartial when presenting grey morality. There is a conflict in Monster, for example, where a doctor is really reserved about killing the villain, when he is supposed to save lives instead of taking them away. And yet it becomes clear pretty fast that he will save hundreds of lives if he indeed kills the villain. The moral conflict is there, alright, but it's not really grey. B. The second problem is when a show uses double standards in its morality, so it can bend its logic in any way it likes. In Hunter x Hunter, for example, there is a very interesting concept regarding humanoid bugs which kill people. On one side, they are evil because they kill for fun. On the other, they are just following their instinct. And it becomes even more bizarre after it is revealed that they are in fact people which retain the memories of their former lives. The heroes who are sent to kill them are basically killing humans, not monsters. And the monsters are not always killing people as much as mutating them into more bugs. This fascinating concept is ruined when they constantly switch the behavior of the bugs to feel as if they are one-dimensional monsters in one episode and misunderstood humans with an identity crisis in another. It's very hard to know what they are as a whole because they don't act in a specific way. A similar thing happens with all empowerment fantasy titles, which are constantly using double standards to make the hero look cool and the villains to look despicable, even when they are essentially doing the same thing. Notorious cases include meritocracy in Mahouka, treatment of women in Sword Art Online, and talent in No Game, No Life. They are essentially being pretentious and twist words and situations in order to present the same reason with different rationality. Bottom line, reason has to do with making sense of things, and is closer to impersonal logic. You are basing everything on actions and facts. Rationality is the quality or state of being reasonable, and it has to do mostly with personal bias. It's how you reach the conclusions and make decisions based on what you know, or what suits you the most. And the thing with rationality is that it can easily twist the logic so something can mean whatever you like it to mean. Especially when you include emotional state, morality values, profit, personal beliefs, even faith. You can make anything to sound true or false, and when confronted, you can just call it your opinion, so nobody can judge it. And that is what we call irrational.
It had some of the best writing I've ever seen in anything. I don't like reading. It's just not my thing, it's confusing.